Okay, we continue to discuss the most interesting facts related to nutrition and diets. And today we'll talk about the facts related to our dietary changes over the last 12,000 years. And we start with a very interesting one. Today, 71% of calories in the typical Western diet comes from the foods that did not exist 12,000 years ago. 71%! Which means humanity introduced a lot of new foods, like grains, dairy products, vegetable oils, refined sugars in a really short period of time. And there's growing evidence that these changes in human diet happened way too fast on an evolutionary time scale for our digestive system to adapt. This is why we have so many food-related health issues and so many diets. Hi, Andrew here. Welcome to the Practical Health Channel. One big change that happened around 10,000 BC was the introduction of grains. Fact number two, the share of grains in the typical Western diet went up from basically 0% in the Old Stone Age, 12,000 years ago, to about 24% today. And 85% of that is refined grains, thanks to mechanical processing of grains. Are refined grains a good thing? Well, not exactly. We want unrefined grains as part of our diet, with all those diverse and greatly rich nutrients. Basically, the closer you can get to eating straight out of the wheat field, the better for you. Since we're already talking about carbohydrates, grains are predominantly carbohydrates. Here comes fact number three. Today, we eat 10 times more sugars than we did 200 years ago. 10 times more anything is usually too much. Imagine you need to use the bathroom 10 times more every day, or drinking 10 times more coffee every morning. Our sugar consumption went up from about 6.8 kilograms per year in 1815 to about 69.1 kilograms in 2000, altogether contributing 19% to our diet. No wonder the obesity spiked up during the last century. What about fats? Fact number four. On average, an American consumes 16 kilograms of cooking oils, three times more than 50 years ago. On the other hand, today, meats, fish, dairy products contribute smaller share of calories to our daily diet than 50 years ago. Okay, what about the total number of calories? Fact number five. The average American consumed about 2,500 calories a day in 2010, about 23% more than in 1970. What do all these numbers mean? They mean that both quantity and quality of our foods deteriorated in a very short time frame. Our digestive system has not managed to completely adjust to these changes that have happened for the last 12,000 years. And these changes are only accelerating. Okay, so depressing. But did the last century do something good for our diet? Yes, yes, yes. Fact number six. We discovered and started paying attention to vitamins and minerals. So there is at least something good in our dietary evolution. That's it for today. You can see that we are living in such a fast timeline of dietary changes. Maybe all we have to do is to take it slow, really slow, and pay a little more attention to ourselves and the things we put on our plates every day. See you next time. Bye.